Hans is an internationally famous climber. He remains the only climber to hold the national title in speed and the national title in difficulty concurrently. He won the first world championships in speed climbing in 1991, and Hans has won 11 U.S. national champion titles in the last 17 years. He has also won gold 3 times in the ESPN X-Games. Hans Florine holds the speed record on the most famous route, on the most famous climbing cliff, in the most famous climbing area in the world, the 3,000-foot nose route of El Capitan in Yosemite National Park, California. Hans has climbed the nose in under 3 hours.
He's just a champion in all regards in climbing, and I just want you to give him a warm Indy Mac helm. Welcome to Hans Florine. Come on up, Hans.
Really slow coming up here after Bill Brooks this morning said, you know how motivational speakers come up here. As the saying goes, time is money, and Indy Mac is obviously doing an incredible job at valuing the customer's time, and that's why they give you their money. So the old record was 324, we did it in 248. Became the number one best-selling book amongst salespeople in mortgage lending banking industry. So, high altitude was really getting to me. And I didn't know who wrote this, but this morning, Bill told me Marcus Aurelius wrote this from the Roman Empire. If you can conceive, you can achieve, which is a Latin for if you can conceive, you can achieve. But again, the brain cells were kind of dead then.
And business. Please welcome Hans Florine.
Hans has spoken to hundreds of audiences in 6 countries. He wrote the book on speed climbing, now in its 2nd edition. His business degree, certification in operations management, along with his achievements in climbing, make for a memorable and unique message.
I know what all you're thinking. Does he talk as fast as he climbs?
He has brought his speed on the vertical into his speaking, writing, business, and family life.
But folks, that is the smile on my face from my biggest day of climbing ever. My most rewarding, my most exhausted. So these people change your perspective, and there's like paradigm shifts. You think, you know, you'll never meet Mark Burns' sales goal. Well, you can crush him like a little bug. Yeah. But this is my friend Mike Lopez. Me and Mike got invited to go to Aconcagua, the highest summit in South America, with Eric. And so we did a training hike on Shasta. Just a little quick story. Got up early a.m., hiked up. You know, there's like good visibility. Go a couple hours, there's only 100-foot visibility. A couple more hours, only like 50-foot visibility. That's okay. I had a compass.
I'm looking at
Mike. He's looking at me, and we're just like, oh, man. I'm a little nervous because I don't know where we're on the mountain, and we know what we got to do. We got to tell a blind guy that we're turning around because there's only 10-foot visibility, right? Shoot from there over to there. You have all these incredible tools, but you know your competitors have the same tools. So what it comes down to, really, is how you use the tools. Who's going to use them the fastest? You know, every decade you got to improve. You got to get faster. You got to get better. I could leave you with this great shot of this overview, looking down from the top of being the top 8 mortgage lending banks in the nation. But I'm going to leave you guys with a challenge for 2005. A challenge to send me a picture of you guys after working your hardest day ever or week ever, improving business for Indy Mac and yourself, and try to beat this shot. Thanks, everyone.
And in alpine environment, kind of the roots of climbing, speed is success. If you can't make it to the summit and back before Mother Nature throws a storm at you, then often slowness is failure.